Can you remember anything? Is there anything from when you were changed?
It was like a dream.
About what?
Rage. Power. And freedom.
Hulk smash! Bloody hell, that was harsh. Hi guys, how's it going? It's good to be back in the corner. I haven't been here for a long time. And today I'm going to be talking about one of my favourite Marvel superheroes, and it's Hulk. But no, I'm not going to be talking about the up-to-date Hulk. And no, I'm not going to be talking about the abomination that was Ed Norton's Hulk from 2003, directed by Ang Lee, starring Eric Banner, Jennifer Connelly, Josh Lucas, Sam Elliott, and Nick Nolte. It's Hulk!
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we go home. Just a perfect day. Feed animals in the zoo. Then later, a movie too, and then home. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep. Just a perfect day. Problems all left alone. Weekenders on our own. It's such fun. Just a perfect day. You made me forget myself. I thought I was someone else, someone good.
Puny human.
Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep me.
Now, over the years, this film has got absolutely slayed. People said it was too thoughtful, too sensitive, too slow. Like it was just too dramatic, too serious. Personally, I don't find anything wrong with that. I've actually just watched this film again for the first time in best part of 5 years, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. The great thing now is, this film's nearly 15 years old, and it looks brilliant. Industrial Light & Magic did the special effects for this, and they created this wonderful and incredibly detailed and very human Hulk. I'm not talking about human in the way he looks, because obviously he's a giant green rage monster, but I'm talking about how he moves and everything like that. And it really does stand the test of time. I mean, fair enough, there are moments in it where you think, oh, why didn't you just make that bit of the Hulk look as good as that bit of the Hulk? But nonetheless, it looks fantastic. Now, one thing that I really, really like about this film is that there's several different stages about the Hulk. You know, as he gets angrier. For example, his first time he transforms, he's almost like baby Hulk. I mean, he's about eight, maybe 9 feet tall, but he looks very young, he looks very fresh. He looks very clean, like a newborn baby. And it's absolutely brilliant. He looks fantastic, like I say. And there's a fantastic moment where Josh Lucas confronts Bruce Banner. At this point, he doesn't realise he's going to transform into the Hulk. He basically starts a fight with Bruce. Little does he know that you really shouldn't make him angry. And again, another fantastic moment of the Hulk transforming. And it's really, really great. You've got to watch it. If you haven't seen it, just check this out.
Hands off of me. Asshole, I want to talk to you. Listen to me, my father's going after Betty.
What makes you think you can go behind my back and get Ross to cut me out?
Listen to me, Betty's in trouble!
You pathetic freak.
Betty's in danger, I swear to you, she'll be killed.
I can state the obvious. Something tells me you aren't in much of a position to be making stupid threats to anyone.
Yeah? You're making me angry.
Oh, am I?
The script is really, really spot on as well after you've turned the volume up because you can't hear a word anyone's saying. And it's very, very human, but very true and staying true to the nature of the Hulk and what they were doing in the comics in the first place. This is a really, really great version of the Hulk. I think if you are going to invest yourself in the cinematic universe of the Hulk, you really need to watch this film. It's far more poignant than the terrible Incredible Hulk with Ed Norton in. I mean, that film is just a shambles of a movie. But there's one thing, again, about this is that when they really captured the power of the Hulk, like I mentioned earlier, about him transforming, the angrier he gets, the bigger he gets, the deeper of green that he gets. Putting that on screen is a special thing for us fanboys. It really, really is. Like, there's a great moment when all these guys are just surrounding him with machine guns, and as the bullets are bouncing off him, he gets angry, and the Hulk actually looks at his own hand as it gets bigger and bigger, and he bursts out with more of his clothing. And at this point, he must get to like 20 feet tall. I mean, this is incredible. And again, it's really, really spectacular to see on screen. And one of my favourite bits, the big, big action sequence in this film with the Hulk, and it's where he's been locked up in the desert and they were trying to extract some of his DNA. He escaped. He just wants to calm down, but the government won't let him do that. So they're attacking him from every angle with all these attack helicopters. And he's running like 300 miles an hour. Great moments where he's just bounding across the desert. Danny Elfman, who does the soundtrack to this film, who previously did like the soundtrack to Batman, and he also did the soundtrack to the Spider-Man movies as well, starring Tobey Maguire. But personally, I think this is probably one of his better soundtracks. It really is, because he really does capture the primal, that kind of monstrous, earthly feeling of the Hulk, especially when he's bounding across the desert. Enjoyed that. Now again, talking about how the Hulk looks, again with this action sequence, there's moments where you think, is that really CGI? Because it looks that good. I mean, yeah, fair enough, there are moments where people usually take the piss out of it, say it looks a bit like Shrek. Yeah, that's just one of those moments of CGI where you think, well, why didn't you just keep him a bit neater? Why couldn't you just tidy up his features a bit more? But let's go through the cast now. Eric Banner, originally was a stand-up comedian, and the first time I saw him was in the film Chopper. And I thought, it's like a biopic of this Australian criminal. Fantastic bit of acting from Eric Banner. And I understand he spent a lot of time with Chopper Reed before he made the film. I thought, yeah, this will be interesting. Now, he did come across as being a bit too quiet, a bit too calm.
You know what scares me the most is that when it happens, when it comes over me and I totally lose control, I like it.
But then again, this is an Ang Lee movie who wanted to make a very thoughtful film about The Incredible Hulk. I mean, he certainly does a better job than Ed Norton did, put it that way. And Jennifer Connelly, the beautiful Jennifer Connelly, she plays Betty. She plays it spot on. And she has this kind of ethereal look about her. When she kind of, she's there to try and calm Hulk down in certain moments of the film. And you truly believe that her gaze would do that. You do almost kind of just go, oh, aren't you lovely? Now, Sam Elliott plays General Ross, and that's a perfect piece of casting. He really does get it absolutely spot on. He comes across as being so disciplined.
For now, all further contact is out of the question.
And the great thing about Sam Neill is he's a proper man as well, you know. He's a great actor and a legendary actor at that. Now we'll come to Nick Nolte. Now, he doesn't look well in this film, Nick Nolte. At this point, he was a heavy-duty alcoholic. I mean, this guy looks rough. He looks tired, withdrawn. The funny thing is he actually plays the part perfectly, and the way he looks is perfect. But he has this really insane vocal about him.
By nature, knowledge of oneself. It's the only path to the truth that give men the power to go beyond God's boundaries.
I can't help but feel that if this film didn't get kind of the bad rap that it did, is that Nick Nolte should have really got like an Oscar nomination, because he's absolutely amazing. He really is. He steals the entire movie when it comes to acting. Like I said, there's some great, great moments. And it is like watching Shakespeare when he starts spouting off. It really is.
I got news for you. I didn't come here to see you. I came here to see my son.
I can only imagine that there's some moments where Ang Lee just said, go on, Nick, you just go for it. You improvise. You go with the flow. You get into this character.
You're nothing but a superficial shell, a husk of flimsy consciousness.
It was a brilliant performance. Now, Josh Lucas plays a character called Talbot, and like I say, he works for the government, and all he wants to do is harvest Bruce Banner's DNA.
Bad science, maybe, but personally gratifying.
To be honest with you, he's a bit of an arsehole, and he plays the part perfectly well. Now, I'll talk about the editing in this film. Yeah, you kind of watch it, and you actually become quite amazed at some point, because it is like reading a comic. There's like shots within shots, and images coming out of other images, and the transitions between scenes. I love them. They're really, really great. I mean, there are moments, and you think, that's really unnecessary. You know, there'd be some bizarre kind of overlaying edit when someone kind of walks through a door. So you've got like two camera angles, one camera angle here and one camera angle here, and they'll just sort of pan across each other like that. And you think that's a bit unnecessary. Other than that, the majority of the edit in this film is absolutely perfect, and you really do get sucked into this comic book style, this comic book movie. And it really does make you feel like you're part of it. And all you want to do, you feel like you're like turning a page in the book. And I really love that about this film. Now, I mentioned Danny Elfman doing the soundtrack. It's a great jump from kind of the Tim Burton-esque soundtracks that he used to do. Not really as much with Batman, because that soundtrack was absolutely awesome, but when he did like the soundtrack to Tim Burton movies like Edward Scissorhands and things like that, they all just seemed the same, very dark and moody. This one, he really does explore different avenues, different instrumentals, which I really enjoyed, and it really does make the movie and bring it all together perfectly. Now, all in all, this film just doesn't deserve the bad rap that it's got over the years. I really do think that everyone should just give it a second chance. Yeah, it's a bit slow, but if you watch it once, watch it twice, watch it three times, you really do get engrossed in it all, and you really do believe in all these characters, and you believe in the world that Ang Lee was trying to put on screen. It's a great movie. It's far superior to Incredible Hulk. Take into account, this is pre-Disney, so this is the first proper Marvel movie that you did, and I love it. I can't wait to get on Blu-ray. Anyway, guys, thanks very much for watching. Next, I'll be doing The Incredible Hulk. I really do think you should watch that one, because I've got a lot to say. Thank you very much for watching, guys. It's always a pleasure. Peace out, and we'll see you next time.
Estas personas están ayudando a nuestros enemigos. Posiblemente. Tú también. ¡Coge eso! ¡Es ya propiedad del gobierno!
Me está enojando.
No le gustaría verme enojado.